Hey, welcome back, and in today's video, we have some guru drama, some James Charles drama. I'm going to be talking about it. You know, you've probably heard about it, the kodeerants reaction with their eyes, the whole thing like that. I've seen a lot of other YouTubers cover it. I was asked if I could do my opinion on it, feeling like that's something I can do, and I feel like I could deliver it to you in a nice, straight, arrow,
I want to make it very clear. The hives that I'm getting on my eyes are not from my makeup remover or base. I've used both of the products for years. Never had hives from them. I use them literally every day. I got a sister slay wherever I go.
She's got a sister slay wherever she goes. Now, I heard a lot of, that's right, Greg. I heard a lot of people talking about this. And apparently red is a color that just causes a lot of irritation with a lot of people. And I do want to go ahead and point out that red is not just a thing that is difficult to get out of your skin, apparently, but also in your hair. I actually have a red tint still in my hair from the red and the pink that I use. The red dyes in general are just very difficult and very sensitive. When I was dyeing my girlfriend's hair, she actually had a reaction to the color as well. It's just something that happens, especially if you're already sensitive to the dye.
Did not warn me about the staining. He didn't tell any of us. I watched all his promotions on the palette. He didn't say that it would look like I have goddamn eyeshadow on still after I tried to remove it. Like, look at me. He took pink dye to a whole new level. I've been trying all the...
When I looked into this initially, I did find out that there actually was a warning on the actual box. Also noticed that James Charles was very super excited about this color. He had some sentimental value in it. But because he had the sentimental attachment, I'm thinking that he put a lot of extra care into this color. Let's hear him.
Corner. This shade is called Skip in honor of my father. This is his favorite color in the entire palette, and Skip is his nickname that every single one of his friends call him. This pink shade in the formulation, I am so incredibly proud of. Just like you're kidding, it is one of my favorite shades in the entire palette, and I know that my father is very, very proud of me as well and all the work that I put in. It just means a lot that I was able to name a shade after him for this palette, and that is the rainbow. All complete. Sisters, those are...
Now, I know what you're thinking. I do want to see his arm too to see if there's a stain there. Now, I'm not real big into the beauty scene. I don't know if it's common knowledge about the dyes in the colors, especially the intensities in the red and pink and purple colors. I know though that in general, reds are hard and difficult to get out of anything, especially if you've ever messed around. If you went to your local Sally's and got into the red hair dyes and stuff like that, you know how hard it is to get that stuff out. It's extreme, but...
Smooth, creamy mattes. You want the pigment to be off the chain. You gotta use red dyes, because if you are a vegan brand, you cannot use carmine. Now, what is carmine? Carmine is what a lot of brands who test on animals or who are not cruelty-free use in their pigments to really get rich red shades. Now, what is carmine? You can do a quick Google search. I'm gonna tell you right now. It is basically crushed beetles that people use in makeup to get red pigment. I wish I could make it up. It's been happening for years. So carmine is actually very common in cosmetics. It's safe, but if you are not into wearing insects on your eyes, you have to use pigment. So a lot of these red dyes can stain the eye area. So on the back of the box, you will see that it says some of the shades are not really allowed near the immediate eye area. So
he even has a disclaimer on the back of his box too. James Charles definitely did have one in the back of his box as well. And I'm guessing that kodeerants just didn't see it. I don't know. Maybe she just didn't pay attention to things like that and she was just jumping on in. Can't really say.
It is kind of a warning for people with sensitive eyes. So if you are someone that when you wipe off your makeup, you don't want like your lid stained pink or any like residue in there, then you...
It really just seems very straightforward. And I am developing an opinion.
Colors because I wanted to make a review video on it for my YouTube channel. I can safely say you should skip using the color Skip. People are trying to say because it's a pressed pigment that I should know that pressed pigments can stain. None of the others did this.
Well, none of the others did that, more than likely because it's the red dye. The red dyes, not just in makeup, but in hair color and everything, are just extremely hard to get out. And because they are going with cruelty-free and vegan products like that, they didn't want to use the carmine, the crushed beetle. And so they had to go this route. But it seems to me that these colors are basically the straight up dye. It's not diluted as in most other eyeshadows, I'm told, is actually diluted. This is a straight color, so this is something that's gonna happen. But you should know yourself that you are sensitive and you are allergic and stuff like that. And then I found out she did know that.
All I wanted my followers to know, I didn't care if you responded, I didn't care if it went viral, I don't care. I just wanted to warn people because it hit people. I don't know what happens to people. I hear people get hurt. And I feel like if something's going to cause someone physical harm, I should tell someone, right?
I am 100% in agreement with the fact that if something's going to cause someone harm, yes, go ahead and tell them. But here's the thing about that. Every person is different. We have different makeups, biochemistries, and just things like that. She should know herself that she is very sensitive and she has allergic reactions and stuff like that. And maybe she's gonna be that way, but maybe the next person's not. I mean, yeah, she had a friend that she said the same thing happened to her. And I do want to point out the fact that if her friend knew that happened to her, then why in the heck would she put it on her eyes as well? But yeah, everybody's different. What's sensitive to this person might not be sensitive to this person. And like I said, oh, shouts out the drama investigator for providing this. But like I said, she knew that she was allergic to most everything. Check this out.
I don't think what you have is hives, because hives spread all over the body. Bitch, I know what hives are. I get hives every fucking day of my life. I have severely sensitive skin. I will tell you that. I have sensitive skin, but I...
Now, well, hold on a second now. She just admitted that she gets hives all the time. She just admitted that she has severely sensitive skin. And like I said, I've dyed other people's hair, and then when we got into the red colors, some people had an reaction. I don't have a reaction when I put red on my hair. Nothing, but I've dyed people's hair where they broke out with a rash. I mean, that's just, some people are so sensitive. She knew she was sensitive. We have her on video saying that she breaks out in hives all the time. I don't know. I just kind of feel like, familiar with makeup or not, she should have known that. I really don't think this is James Charles's fault. He could be not sensitive to this stuff. And as far as I'm concerned, as I went out there and I've looked, no one else has any bad reviews on stuff like this. Nobody else has any bad reviews on James Charles's makeup. Mostly everything's positive. My opinion is developed. I'm just really kind of feeling like after she was called out, it was probably a little bit embarrassing. I mean, she's still a new content creator, so more than likely she really didn't want to fess up. I've seen this happen a lot with inexperienced content creators. They don't do enough research. Maybe they put a point out there and then they think that this is going to get them a lot of attention, and then boom, they were wrong. I think that she should have fessed up. But also, in the other end of the spectrum, James Charles could have been a little bit more vocal. Yes, there was a warning on the box, but in his promotions, he could have did what Jeffree Star did. He could have said, hey, if you're sensitive to this stuff, you might want to be careful. And in fact, he fessed up to that later on. In a tweet on Kodee Rants's Twitter, the screenshot says, this was a very well said video. You hit it right on the nail. And the honest truth is that no, because of the fact that I do not do reviews and I've never touched on ingredients on my channel, I did not even think to touch on the risks in my video, nor did I know about them because I don't have sensitive skin. And I have always just used palettes put in front of me with no issue. I definitely agree that I should have mentioned it and warned people with sensitive eyelids of the staining. I released this palette with fellow makeup artists in mind to see what looks they could create. So I'm gonna put the rest of this tweet so you can read it in the description below. This was my assumption. I really do feel like I've hit the nail on the head with the eh. But that's the beauty guru drama. The guru gossip for the week. As interesting as this is, there's always something that's more interesting to me. That's right, you guessed it. I want to know what you think. So why don't you go ahead and leave your creative and interesting responses in the comment box below. Thumbs up, thumbs up. As always, brothers and sisters, I will see you in the next video. I mean, she knew that she broke out in hives all the time. She knew how sensitive her skin was. And I do feel like it's a little bit of common knowledge how hard and difficult it is to get reds out anyways. Red dyes, hard to get out. People do have reactions, like I said. Maybe he should have said something vocally, but he did put a warning on his palate. Well, I know that you're ripping if you're not ripping, you're gagging. How do you become a member of the Red Squad? All you gotta do is subscribe, notification channel, be in the comment section to every single video, because I'm gonna be there. Greg the Cat's gonna be there, and the rest of the Red Squad community as well. And I expect to see you there too, because this channel loves you.
Maybe I should start putting makeup on in my channel.